I can feel like a little judgment of certain people. Like, she shouldn't be doing that, or this is too much for her.
Oh my God, look at that beauty. Look at that beautiful girl. Her mom is gonna fall in love with her all over again.
Anna's been working all day long. She's having rehearsals all week long. Like every day she's working from 10 in the morning until like around 5. And today she had a feeding after rehearsal, which makes 6:48 p.m.
As you can see, I brought Julie to the groom. That's something that Anna was really looking forward to do this week, but she didn't have the time and I ended up doing it. I also have like a cleaning lady to come to the apartment, and the apartment is beautiful, clean, just the way she wanted. I'm gonna cook her some dinner and hopefully she's gonna have a relaxing night.
And I also got her yellow flowers, which is one of her favorite flowers.
You need help, my love. Oh my God, Christmas? You tired, my love? Yeah.
Você tá a coisa mais linda desse mundo.
How's your day?
Long.
I know, I
had a long time. Not good too. A lot of people are curious about my dancing and my pregnancy. Like, a lot of comments we get is like, you should not be dancing, or they're questioning, should I be dancing or should I be performing while pregnant? So Juno separated some of those questions and I'm gonna answer the best of my capability. I'm also new to this, but I do have amazing professional dancers. They are also moms and I've been talking to them a lot and getting also my questions answered. To be honest, there are genuine questions. How far do I plan to dance on my pregnancy and things like that. But there are also, I can feel like a little judgment of certain people, like, she shouldn't be doing that, or this is too much for her, and things like that.
Right.
And I feel like maybe if I wasn't a professional dancer and this was something that I never did in my life, yes, I would agree that's too much. But this is something I do my whole life, so my body is conditioning to do that.
So the first question is it safe to continue dancing while pregnant?
Yes, it's safe because as a dancer, I know my body and I know how much I can do. It's the same as if I have an injury. I don't stop right away. I keep performing, but then I modify some movements in order to be able to keep on dancing. Unless it's a major injury where I have to stop. Also the case with pregnancy. If I did had complications in my pregnancy, my doctor would tell me, you should not dance or you should not exercise. But I also ask those questions to our doctors. We have many different doctors.
Yes, we do.
And they all say it's safe until I feel like it's safe, the movements. Because I was really specifically asking about movements. Like, should I bend forward? Should I bend back? Should I avoid jumps? Should I avoid being partnered? All the doctor says, you do it, and then if you feel uncomfortable or if you feel pain anyway, mm-hmm. you stop doing it.
At the first visit we went just to talk to the doctor, we were like, can't you dance? Can't you do this? Can't you do that? Like, we had so a load of questions because we wanted to be, you know, after a miscarriage, we're kind of like, okay, let's go slow with everything, walk like on eggshells.
That's also the reason, like, because in my first pregnancy, I didn't have those fears because I witnessed a lot of my friends, they are moms and professional dancers, dancing throughout their pregnancy,
like
up
big
into
bellies.
7-8 months. So I know it's doable. I know they didn't do the whole class, or sometimes they didn't perform certain pieces,
The modified,
yeah, and they pick and choose what they can do. So I knew it was safe, but because I had the miscarriage, and this is also I asked when I had the miscarriage, right. Like if that's
we were performing.
Something I did.
We were performing
yes.
when you had the miscarriage, and
yes.
then we were like, the first thing we thought was like, well,
was
is it because we were dancing? And then we just found out that it wasn't the problem.
She said, there's nothing to do with it. I couldn't do anything about it. The reason for my miscarriage last year was because of bad formation of the fetus.
Your body wasn't
like,
ready.
The pregnancy wouldn't go through. But because of that, this time around, I did got more concerned.
Trust me, we had so many questions. We've been dancing for our whole life, so we know that sometimes we push ourselves and we're trying to get back in shape, and like right now we're rehearsing something really
demanding
on the body. So we wanted to make sure everything was fine when we talked to the doctors. And so far, we're doing the right thing. The doctors gave us the reassurance that if you know your body, if you know your limits, you know. The main goal is to feel safe. If she's feeling safe, she's safe.
The things that I chose not to do is jump.
Right.
Being partnered in certain ways, like being lifted,
right.
high lifted, just to avoid falling, like
right.
the same way I stopped riding my scooter.
Like risk. You're
yeah.
not risking anymore. You know very well that you have control of your body, but it's not just you anymore.
Yeah.
There is our little baby there.
Yeah.
So you want to be cautious about it.
Oh, so the rule of thumb that I learned is if I feel uncomfortable, I ask to modify the movement. And if I am out of breath, I have to take a break. Mm-hmm. Those are two signs where I'm going over my limits.
And she's been taking a lot of naps in between, so if there's one thing that Anna knows how to do, is to not pretend. She can't pretend, she cannot do things to make others happy. You know, if she's not happy about it, she's not gonna force anything.
I think this is a pregnant woman thing. I think...
No, you were always like that. You're very focused. So, this is a good thing. So, the place where we're getting the delivery, it's a place where they have a team of doctors. I think the good thing about it is because we learn a lot from different point of views. We can ask all the different questions and they're very open. Every time we come to talk to them, they really explain everything. We're in good hands. And we feel very happy about that team, right? Are you still performing on stage while expecting?
Yes, I am. I gave up doing Nutcracker this year. That's one ballet where I felt like I couldn't do it because it's in December, so I'll be already showing. So I didn't feel like the character wouldn't fit the showing because I would play a teenager. Also,
partnering, it's a lot of partnering.
It's a lot of partnering, it's a lot of holding.
A lot of lift, holding her waist, and a lot of upside down lifts, and so it's a lot.
And it's also in pointe shoes, and I know one of the things that we have to deal with while pregnant is the shift up of balance. Mm. We lose the control of balance a little bit in the body. So I'm not performing the Nutcracker, which is the first time in what? Since 2006.
19 years, something like that.
Yeah.
And since she's not doing this year, I took a break as well.
But I am performing at the Met Opera still. And luckily, I got 3 shows this season that it's okay. Costume-wise, it's okay,
good about that because
they're actually
she's
very
not
good.
The first one to be pregnant on stage at the Met Opera. So the wardrobe department, they are very open to everything. Like do you need room here? Do you need room here?
I'm being fitted pretty much every 2 weeks and they make sure that my costume are not bothering me. They're very good with taking care of me in that way.
So the next question is, how long do you want to keep on dancing before the baby comes?
As long as I can. As long as my body allows me to. As long as I feel comfortable. The season finishes in June. I'm gonna deliver May 11th. That's my due date. So obviously I'm not gonna finish the season, but my plan is to go up into April. But again, it's my plan. They all know things can change, right? And that if I can't do it, then I can do it. But that's my plan, and that will be Toronto. Matter of fact, the dance director at the Met performed in Toronto while she was pregnant. And a lot of performers in Toronto performed that opera when they were pregnant.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
Now that you're pregnant, we're hearing a lot of stories of people performing pregnant and we have no idea.
Yeah, and they say like every high note, the baby kicked and they felt it.
How awesome is that? Like, the babies listen to opera, to the renowned singers from, you know, all over the world, singing all the famous operas and arias.
Yeah.
And the baby's there on stage already.
Yeah.
How cool is that? The next and last question is, what advice can you give to other pregnant dancers?
I feel like I'm still getting advices.
But I think you pass it along right away, right?
Listen to your body, listen to the way you feel. Don't be afraid to take breaks and ask for breaks if they're not giving you enough. Day offs, like, of course, I mean, I feel like once you're pregnant, the thing you were saying about being unapologetic, right. I feel like once you're pregnant, you become unapologetic because you just, there's no option, you know, like when you can't function and that's it. Like
and
there's no other way around.
Something on my side that I feel like it's very noticeable is that you don't have to say anything. It's not that you're sick, you're not sick, you're pregnant, but I'm aware that a lot of changes happen on your body, on your mind and everything. And I feel like everybody around is so respectful of that.
Yeah, because also you feel sick sometimes. You feel without energy. You feel sleepy.
Right.
And I feel like they can also see in my face when my energy is gone, you know? And they all wanted to like...
Yeah, people are very cautious about
pat me on the back,
which is a nice thing. Like it's a very celebratory moment.
Yeah,
like everybody's supportive. Everybody's happy about you. Genuinely, it's like people are like really nice, and they make you feel special. Even me, like the dad, I feel like very special every time.
But I feel like in our group. At the Met, for example, there are a lot of moms there and also husbands with kids.
Families there.
So they
and
all
some of
went,
them already performing. Isn't that crazy?
The big majority of them already went through this. So they are compassionate about us.
Yeah.
Because this is our first time.
Right, if I can add to your advice, everybody will be respectful. Everybody will make you feel seen. People will understand everything that you're going through, so you don't have to worry about anything. And also, like Anna said, your body is your temple, so you know what you're supposed to do in order to protect your little baby. The nature, you know, it's unbelievable how you are so protective already of your temple, you know what I mean? How you fight not to throw up sometimes, how you fight because you need to keep the nutrients. Like sometimes it's not even that, because you're taking everything you need. It's not that you're sick every day, but like you're trying your best to make everything calm and easy for the baby, which is like to you and to all pregnant women out there, because it's a lot. And that's why it's a magical moment. Like the amount of people reaching out to us and sending good vibes and praying, and it's very good. It feels very safe, right? It feels like a very safe community. So we want to thank you guys. Thank you for making us feel this way. It means a lot to us.
Yeah.
And so now, because this lady needs to sleep, she had a long day today.
I actually don't think I can eat.
I know, I thought of that.
You thought?
But you ate throughout the day. You had your snacks in there.
I did. I ate broccoli, tomato.
Nice.
This is it for this week. Hope you guys enjoy our video. And we'll see you next time.
See you next time.